Hi, this is my another one of my weekly growth videos for King of Avalon. It's quite a bit later than you're used to from me. I was quite busy in the weekend, and yeah, Monday I thought I'm going to wait another day because yeah, there were quite some things in my account that I could finish today, so I did that. I actually just made two different videos on that. One of them is that I finally did my lucky shot for the gemstones. We'll get into that later. And I also completed my Stronghold 34 and did my university speed build, my university 34, and did some speed researching. That was all done today. Made two separate videos on that. On this, I will also touch upon that. And yeah, also just the normal stuff, I would say. So let's first look at the heroes. So this after I had my Arthur's Soul to 3 stars, I switched back to to transferring horns. So that's what I've done. Before doing this, let's first open the crates. Often almost forget about that and some other stuff that I still have. A lot of this stuff, not that there is that much useful things in there, but okay. I opened actually during the week quite some of these so these also contain quite some summoning horns, which is nice. It's also open this, don't know how I got these normally. Maybe they're already there for a while. Normally I don't take them anymore, but maybe I have joined some rally by accident, let's put it like that. Oh, that's very nice amount. 39,107. How very nice. I mean, it is let's say quite nice. But I'm happy with it, very happy. I mean, sometimes you get a lot less than 2 batches for each of the chests or the keys, I should. And the keys are the limiting factor, so it's actually quite quite nice. Anything. Well, okay, let's not look at those yet. So I'm going to do the summoning, see what I get. Could be that after this I'm going to say, oh, I'm going to switch back to doing specific specific heroes. So what do I got here? Got Sir K 10, Sir Baldwin 4, Elaine of Carlo 4. Not that impressive, I would say. But yeah, the thing is that transferring is also only like 14 per week. So that's also not that great. I'm still a bit in doubt. So Sir Baldwin, Elaine 46, Sir K 37, Tristan 8. Might do a bit more with I could still do more here, at least do another level of the 4 stars when I get there, but I don't think I'm going to spend extra on that. Oh, let's before I forget, let's change that one. And I think, yeah, it's always with the attack ones, that that one says infantry defense, which is a nice one, is maxed. But here bowman defense is just not that interesting, so to max these is going to cost quite a lot. Yeah, not that interested. This one is interested, but I think about replacing it. This one, bowman health, also not that interesting. Similar here, cavalry defense, cavalry health, quite interesting, but okay. I still think I'm going to see if I can do a little bit more here on LOS. She's also not going that fast anymore. Just missed that last one, and then I'm not going to use it up completely. That for next time. But yeah, we do have another couple of levels and a little bit of an increase, not that much, but 1.65%, I think, if I saw that correctly. So that's quite nice. So that's it for the heroes. I think I'm going to keep going with my summoning horns to transfer those. Not completely sure. Might also start to focus a bit. Ultimately, I would really like all of them to 3-star, or of course all of them to the max stars. But yeah, the question is how best to achieve that. This was it was not a very bad result, the heroes that I got, but also not something I got very excited about. So yeah, just leave it. Okay, as we switched to the buildings, as I've already mentioned, I did finish my Stronghold 34 speed build, my University 34, and now I'm actually doing my Hall of War. It's a building that was still lacking at 28, now doing 29. Might do 30 after that, not yet sure. Probably will in one of these days. And what I'm probably going to do afterwards, or what I should do afterwards, is focus on the resource buildings. Maybe do some hospitals, always useful as well. And might even do military tents. And probably keep doing that for a while. Maybe do my wall for the next upgrade event in 2 weeks. But probably keep on the cheaper things for a while. And just working on those until I get my Stronghold 35, because that's the next goal. And that is, we only need university that I've already done, and the wall. So the wall is the only thing. And I already have 300 of the 1,000 noble badges. So that's also going quite well. So I just keep working on that. For the prestige levels, I believe, I'm not completely sure anymore, but I believe I had done a barracks level. And probably I just keep on doing whatever I can. They're not that much. At a certain moment there will not be that many choices. But also the new levels are quite expensive. So you, for example, look at another Stronghold level, which is nice, but it's going to cost more than I accumulate in a week. So probably I don't get into a problem that I don't have anything useful to assign it to. But nothing really special there that I'm focusing on. So for the research, for people that haven't just seen the other video that I made on this, is that I did the third level of all these projects. Finished with that one that I'm probably keep running out for a while at least. So that's quite nice. That's also going to give quite some nice increase in boost. So I'm quite happy with that. Now probably going to do some cheaper combat 2 combat economy research while I wait until my my Stronghold 35 and my University 35. Still quite some time to go, but that's the next focus, and then I then can do some speed research again and really finish combat 2 as far as I want to finish it, because the siege projects I'm probably not going to spend on at all. So for the gear, I'm now forging my first Ice Lord piece. And as I mentioned, I'm going to do them one by one and keep my Death Seeker until I really have a complete Ice Lord set, and also have it probably enhanced to level 5, because I really don't want to miss out on any of those damage and damage reduction boosts. So that's the problem. Any Ice Lord lower than enhanced to level 5 will have less damage and damage reduction boost than Deathseeker 5. Of course, the other boosts are going to be better. I think there is, in general, people feel that Ice Lord enhanced to level 3 is starting to get better than Deathseeker 5. But I'm just a bit stubborn, I guess, from that point of view. But anyway, I'm working on it, and it's going quite okay. I'm not doing anything special for it, but you do get quite a lot of ingredients these days via Firelands, the Ultimate Alliance Conquest, and the Demonic Siege. Okay, for the lucky shot, I'm completely out of coins. I have just done this field. Oh, it's still open up, so that got me quite a bit further with my gemstones. So I still have to see what I'm going to do next with Lucky Shot. I don't know yet. Looking at the gemstone, I now have for my Deathseeker piece, I all have almost all F soul stones. So this one was particularly nice as a result from the Lucky Shot. I still have to get another one. I don't think I'm going to focus on getting that, because that will cost me another complete Lucky Shot field. This was actually the last reward that I got, so it's going to cost you 246 if it happens like that. This one I am going to get from the Spire Loot. I need 30 more fragments, so then I can do that as well. And I do plan to focus a bit more that I've been lacking to transfer the, I think, what is it called, this gemstone essence or whatever, from my farm accounts. So far I've not really focused on that, but I will try if like now there are special events that can give these kind of rewards, refining stones and the like. I'm going to try to focus more on that, hit more monsters, for example. Normally I'm not really doing that in my farms, or do more barb rallies. And in other ways, doing necessary things. And yeah, probably also try to, in my farms, can actually also buy these refining stones, which I'm probably going to try to do more, and maybe convert some other stuff so that I can keep transferring those gemstone essence from my farms to my main, so that I can keep enhancing my gemstones, because the gemstones are actually a very important way to get boosts, and I've been lacking there. Can be clear on that. Okay, for the dragon, I'm now working towards 59, and I believe I've already improved all my upgraded all my assault skills to the level that I can. I might later also start to get some guardian points, because for example this one I can still improve quite some levels. It's going to be expensive, but I can improve quite some levels, and that is going to give me some nice extra infantry health, so I might start to focus on that as well. Currently I have not spent my credits on that, and I definitely have to do that, because you don't get so much from just normal gameplay to get you to that higher level. So for the rest, just getting my dragon to 59, and then I'm going to focus on assault points again to get all the projects leveled up. But the way it looks now, getting the assault points is quite easy via what you can buy in the Spire Loot. Getting the dragon XP is a lot tougher. Okay, for the prestige, for the emblems, I'm close to getting all to level 4. Only this one left, one of the defense ones, and then I can get the other ones to level 5. Probably start with the troop attack, defense, health ones, and so on. So that's just going slowly, but I keep focusing on it. For the prestige statues, nothing really new. Just keep focusing on it. And for the artifacts, just yeah, I was waiting with improving one of them or improving. I thought I'd just do that because I have a lot of ingredients for getting a purple one, and if I now remove and dismantle this one, I get 600, and that is more than enough to be able to craft my first purple one. And purple ones, I believe I should also be able to enhance, so it's quite yeah, interesting to see what that costs. So that's going to cost 300 of these and 1000 of these. Not even that expensive, I would say, but yeah, still quite quite a lot. The increase is quite nice at 12%. So if we compare that to actually the 11% increase I get from blue to purple, of course the cost is also a bit higher. So I'm probably first indeed still going to do the other Bowman one and the other the Cavalry ones, but yeah. Well, it's quite interesting to be able to see that anyway, what it costs to increase. Maybe, just maybe purely for yeah, my website and the stats point of view, I might actually enhance this one first so that I know what are the requirements for the one after this level and so on, maybe. Okay, so that's quite nice. First purple one. Actually, yeah, can activate this dome as well. Can just as well do that now. So that yeah, if I get the ingredients, which is going slowly but steadily, I can also increase those. Okay. What I want to do, and what I shouldn't forget, what I should have done earlier already. Is oh, especially since I have to recall troops now to be able to do this, so I have to yeah, wait a while, 2 minutes before my troops are home and then attacking one of my farms. But I think it's worth it probably to see, because I yeah, increased my stats quite a lot. So that's quite nice. Just want to check because those are still active. It seems so. Yeah, we have to realize that and that those damage stats are actually a bit higher than they normally are because I activated these temporary boosts. You can get them from the labyrinth. I did that for the last Ultimate Alliance conquest. I don't always do that because I find it quite expensive, but this time I yeah, felt a bit more aggressive. Did yeah, more attacking. Normally I already do quite some attacking, but did more. So I got quite some yeah, I spent quite some coins on that to get those. But quite nice, I was able to do quite some hits. It's also zeroed because I stayed in another kingdom when I went to sleep. Luckily, I was able to plunder quite some ore before they kicked me off that mine and zeroed me eventually. I was yeah, traveling in the weekend, so I didn't wasn't able to participate as much as I would like, but was still okay. Let's just attack with one cavalry. I should have my first stats in or my first stat in 1000 now, I think. There has been quite some yeah, various items that I have increased, the gemstones, the the research that I've done, the artifacts that we just saw. Doesn't always oh, last time I didn't seem to not have bookmarked it, so not a good comparison. Hey, how come my stat is not I must be missing something, must have been doing something wrong, because my cavalry attack was already 990. Not sure what is going on. How can things have gone lower? Very weird. Somebody help me. Why can my stats have gone lower? Did I not? Oops, sorry. No, I did have my dragon. Did I not have the? No, that is a big mystery. Something I need to look into. I don't think I'm going to resolve that during this video. That's also a bit boring. In general, I'm still happy with my stats, but I, yeah, I'm of course disappointed that I don't have a 1000% stat yet. Although I'm getting close. And I'm, yeah, I'm very surprised. Okay, anyway, thanks for watching this video. If you have any, yeah, any further, oh, shit, what I did. Sorry, I did something completely wrong. I should have done this, and I was, that explains a lot, so. Sorry about that, just forget the last 5 minutes. Okay, actually this looks a lot better. I actually have three stats. Bowman health, not very useful. Cavalry attack, nice. It's a little bit over 1000. Infantry defense, up quite a bit. That's mostly thanks yeah, to those gemstones that really increased it a lot. Can't believe I made that mistake. I shared it instead of bookmarking it for my specials. So that's very stupid. Anyway, I'm seeing these stats. I'm very very happy. Very happy with the improvement. I think everything is now either all only infantry attack, but that's not an important one at all. But for the other ones, they are in yeah, already far in the 900s or 1000, as some of them are. So yeah, as I said, very very happy with the progress I've made in the past couple of days. So okay, thanks again for watching this video. If you have any suggestions or any yeah, comments or questions, they're also all welcome. I'm also still learning more about the game, so it's much appreciate it as always, and thanks for watching the video.